Hey, you doing, everyone? It is good to have you. Here are two not so obvious and very important ways to shortcut your progress to overcoming any habit or addiction or bad habit that you may have. Just this week, we are starting new high noon groups for groups of individuals who are starting their journey, their sexual integrity journey, to overcoming their addiction and habits with pornography and masturbation in particular. With high noon, we currently have, just this week starting, over 25 new groups, entire groups of men, women of all ages starting new groups together. And they're starting this journey for the next 12 weeks, meeting every single week for about an hour to discuss and to share and to be open and vulnerable and honest and really just get to the bottom of what they want with their lives. So we're starting, I just started my group today, right before I started recording this, and the same themes keep coming up of what is the way to shortcut this, because these individuals have been, my experience of the last few years of helping particularly young men overcome their porn habit, the same theme keeps coming up, and the same methods that can be used for all of them to help shortcut their experience, effectively basically getting rid of this habit and addiction for good. For good, we're talking about, right? And I know that's a bold statement, because we all know anyone who's faced an addiction for a long time, many, many times for many years, or even a decade or more, or many decades, anyone who's been through that cycle knows that a bad habit is something that can't just easily be turned off. So it is a bold statement to say that there is a shortcut to doing this. But if you follow the principles that we're talking about right here at High Noon, there is a way to do that. So what the first tip, the first shortcut or method that we're implementing in our groups, particularly in my groups with my guys, that we found very effective, is recognizing the negative emotions in our lives and understanding how to deal with those negative emotions in a productive way. There is a common theme that keeps occurring over and over and over in the groups. People are saying, oh, I get triggered, or I slip up, or I mess up with my porn habit or whatever addiction I have when I'm stressed, when I'm angry, when I'm frustrated, when I'm having conflicts in my relationship with my parents or with my spouse or my kids or whatever it is. It is always, almost always linked to how we deal with our negative emotions. When the rubber hits the road, when we're faced in a stressful situation, when we are stressed with school, with work, we're having arguments with our spouse or with our boss, if we just don't like somebody, how do you deal with those emotions? With stress in particular, with boredom, which is a form of depression, or with anger or frustration or disappointment. When you just want to escape those emotions and just run off into a different room and take out your phone and go on YouTube, and leads you down this rabbit hole to eventually watching pornography or acting out in your habit. It is simply the matter of how can you manage your emotions in a good way, rather than trying to do what we typically do, is to lean on our habit, to lean on it, on the addiction as a crutch, as a support system for when we're feeling those emotions, to really escape it. And there's nothing more of an instant escape than going onto your phone, than to watching porn. That takes you from this anger and frustration to immediately being relaxed and everything's okay, and just forgetting about those emotions. Emotions are there for a purpose. We have emotions for a reason. And the more we can identify those emotions and not just suppress them with distractions and with our phones or whatever it may be, but actually to let them out, let the emotions out in a productive, healthy way, to talk about them, to communicate about them. This is why, generally speaking here, it is easier for women to know how to manage emotions and to express emotions in a productive way than it is typically for men. This is why also that men are much more susceptible to addictions, to behavior or destructive behaviors, alcohol, video game, excessive video game use, addictions, pornography, drug abuse, etc. It's because, generally speaking, men, women, doesn't matter, people who are not able to manage their emotions in a productive way, to communicate their emotions with somebody, with a partner, with a parent, with a mentor, whoever it may be, typically those people go into isolation, into themselves, go to their phones, and just find more and more destructive ways to escape those emotions that we don't know how to feel. The reality is, if we don't know how to manage our emotions well, then we're just going to be led down to whatever's the most distracting thing for us, which typically is whatever is accessible, most accessible to us, whether it's YouTube, Instagram, which generally leads to more and more stimulating content online, specifically pornography that we're talking about within the groups that we have in High Noon. And the second very important way to shortcut your success to overcoming a bad habit or addiction is very important. But before we get to that, I just want to say, if you found this video helpful at all, I would really appreciate if you give it a thumbs up, give it a like, because it does help this content share with more people. That's what we're trying to do. And if you're new here to High Noon or to this channel, I would encourage you to subscribe if you want, because this is where we're talking about how to gain sexual integrity, how to overcome porn habits, and just live a life that is free and radiant and beautiful, and you're just happy and excited all the time, okay? So if that's you, this is the place for you. All right, so the second very important tip that we've seen so much success with and that we always emphasize from the beginning when people are starting their journey to gain sexual integrity and have control over their life and really be excited about their journey is simply having a very clear goal in mind. We call this at High Noon, we call it the North Star goal. Now, the concept of the North Star goal is creating a goal for yourself that is way more in depth and detailed and tangible and exciting than just, oh, I want to overcome my habit, or oh, I want to be a better person, or oh, I want to be a more generous, more compassionate, like leaving out all the ambiguity of your goal and just making it specifically, who do you want to be? What do you want to be like? Envisioning that for yourself, and what is it going to take to be there, and making everyday habits to get there. The North Star goal should be something that you yourself are truly, truly excited about. It's something that you cannot wait to do every day. It's something ideally that when you wake up and in the morning, you're just so excited to get to work on your goal, or when you come home from work or from school at the end of the day, the first thing you want to do is work on this part of your life, whatever it may be. And the last thing you want to do when you fill your life with things that are so, and something that's so energizing, exciting to you, the last thing you're going to want to do is, guess what? Go back to your old habit, to be bored, to have free time, enough free time to watch porn or indulge in any other destructive behaviors, because this thing is so exciting to you. Whether it's you want to start a business, whether it's you want to start a blog, or you want to start a group, a small group of something, or whether it's you want to learn how to dunk a basketball, or you want to start a team of basketball, or whatever it may be. These are just random examples that I've seen in my own groups, people who've made these, whether it's you want to learn how to play a really complicated song on piano, which is something that a guy of mine did, and his goal was he wanted to perform the song live for people online and stream it online. Like, that's an awesome goal. It got him excited. Whatever it is that you're excited about, whatever it is, you can just throw your whole self and really be filled, thrilled to do. This is a thing, guys, that especially the over-sexualized and hyper-sexualized nature of pornography does very well. What porn does very well is it gives us a temporary, it fills our need temporarily for excitement and thrill, very temporarily. We go instantly from a negative emotion, from stress, from frustration, anger, from boredom, you know, coming home from work and just bored and whatever, you know the experience, and then going from instantly to basically access to hardcore, softcore pornography at any minute through the use of our phone or computer. That is a very temporary innate need we have to experience thrill and excitement in our lives. This is something that God has given us, is an innate need that we have to feel excitement and thrill. But we fill that excitement and thrill with something that's so temporary as pornography, as entertainment, as YouTube, or just scrolling through Facebook, Instagram, whatever it may be that you're indulging in. If we don't fill that need for excitement in our lives with something that's productive and healthy and life-giving to you and to other people, when we can find those things that we can just be excited about ourselves and share with other people, then that is what makes us come alive. For me personally, I love sharing content like this. That's just an example for me. I love creating content for people, and I love just the feedback people say. Like, you know, if someone just says, oh yeah, the point you made, Benjy, really inspired me in this way, or made me think of this way, whatever it is, sometimes I get criticism, and that's fine, because in the end, if I'm able to help just one person, just some people, through sharing my experience and my content online with people, folks, good folks like you, then that is worth it to me, and that is what gets me really excited, and I can't sleep in the morning. As soon as I wake up, I'm thinking about, like, what can I share? What can I do to help? What can I do to help? And that's really like my North Star goal, is always around what kind of experience can I make? What kind of workshop or seminar can I organize for people? Or what kind of content can I share with individuals? So it's entirely up to you, your North Star goal. And that's the second amongst many really helpful ways to do it. So if you want to see more content like that, I would really encourage you to stick around in this channel and also look at other videos on this YouTube channel and give us a thumbs up if that's you, so that this video can be shared with more people through YouTube. All right. Thank you for watching. God bless you. Take care.